Gesteka Lesotho Sun Group of Africa Rally is one of the highlights of the Southern African motorsport calendar. Over more than 20 years, the roof has earned its reputation as one of the world's toughest off-road races, and each year presents a challenge few off-roaders can resist. Each year, both the car and motorcycle categories draw entries from the cream of South African talent, along with competitors from overseas. The pre-race paddock areas were once again a hive of activity. Few motorsport events and certainly no off-road race would be the same without the last-minute preparations. There's always something that has to be fixed, replaced, polished, or stuck onto a vehicle before a car or motorcycle goes through the scrutineering and documentation process. The Roof of Africa was this year the final round in the South African cross-country rally series. With a great deal at stake for championship contenders, nothing was being left to chance. With 3 days of racing ahead over some of the roughest country in Africa, a great deal of attention was being paid to detail. A huge amount of time and effort goes into preparing machinery for an event like the Roof, and during the pre-race formalities, the adrenaline starts to flow. The pre-race preparations are a prelude to the now traditional Round the Houses races. Backed this year by the Alliance Insurance Group, the Round the Houses is not only a race within a race, but turns Maseru, the capital of Lesotho, into a giant carnival. The Round the Houses races are a highlight of the year for many local residents, who queue from early in the morning for the best vantage points. For the competitors, the Round the Houses events also offer an early opportunity to stretch their legs. Some competitors get more of a kick out of the Round the Houses section than others. Much of the racing is highly spectacular, and drivers, riders and the crowd all enter into the spirit of the occasion. Events forming part of the South African cross-country rally series are run over a minimum distance of 1,000 kilometers. One of the beauties of the series is the varied conditions offered up by events which form part of the series. From the mealy fields of the Western Transvaal and the Botswana desert to the mountains of Lesotho, the series provides a true test of man and machinery. A youthful-looking paddy driver won the Roof of Africa in 1972. Driver's been racing for more than 40 years, and back in action in the AAD Video Sport Range Rover, he talked about the tremendous change in off-road racing over the years.
It's like daylight. It's like daylight, I promise you. The speed we were going in the truck, we would have won in 72. Now, 22 years later, I mean, we're running at the back of the field. These Sandmasters with air suspension and 2 feet of travel, whatever it is that they've got, I mean, they just go over the bump. They don't even know the bumps are there. And we're busy gritting our teeth and hanging on and getting headaches and sore necks and God knows what. The sport has changed a hell of a lot.
Among the top contenders was Toyota Desert Race winner Rob Bork.
Ultimately, I'd love to win, but ultimately, I'd also like to finish, because I've actually never finished the Roof. I've won the Roof with Richard as a navigator, which I really enjoyed. But actually driving, I've never finished the Roof, so that's my first challenge. And then obviously, I'd love to win. I mean, that would be the cherry on top.
Defending champions Kasi Kutsia and Richard Leek were aiming to make it 2 in a row.
Your planning here must really be right. You know, I believe in your voertuig heel. You must really be right, but in the same as when I say you must heel, it helps you om your voertuig in the first day to break. And then I think you're going to the second day win. And my voertuig is in a perfect condition. So I think we've got a very good chance. As you first put your strength, you can very good do.
We take another trip down the Roof of Africa memory lane. Franz Čepek won the Roof twice in a row in the late 70s in single-seaters. Franz was back for more this year, with son Franz Jr. doing the navigating in the V-Motors race car.
Well, technology has changed a hell of a lot. Cars are a lot quicker, and the suspensions are a lot better. The handling is a lot better. They all got power steering now. You wouldn't be able to drive these cars without power steering, because they're so big. And well, the wheel travel is doubled or trebled, and the cars are much bigger. They're all built out of chrome moly, all the proper cars, and they're really high tech, and it's a pleasure to drive them.
Once a year, high-speed race machinery disturbs the Lesotho mountain tranquility. One of the most colourful characters in off-road racing is veteran Linton Draper.
I've been coming here since 1977. And since 1989 now, I've not finished the Roof, so
what you saw today was extreme discipline. It was total discipline, which was foreign to me on a racetrack and all the rest of it. And hopefully, all I'm looking for this time is not a win, but a finish, because I reckon if you finish, you have a possibility of winning.
The Round the Houses event on the opening day of the roof is combined with a time trial to determine start positions for racing Section 1 the following day. Also among the pre-race favourites were Springbok, Brooks Carolyn and Jeff Bowling, the turbocharged dealer team Toyota Hilux. A strong showing was also expected from Settlers 400 winners Herman and Karl-Heinz Sulwald. Another Toyota pairing, Springbok's R.P. Reinecker and Lucas Dreyer, won the roof in 1989. Out in the Toyota Land Cruiser, the pair went into the roof lying second in the cross-country series. A strong challenge was also expected from Nick Harper and Daryl Hill in the Rock Oil Raceco. Veteran Harry Roscoe was out in the lubrication equipment Raceco single-seater, normally campaigned by Richard Carolyn. Roscoe doesn't have happy memories of the roof after a huge accident 2 years ago, but in the true spirit of the race, was back for more punishment. Making steady progress in the time trial were Marius and Margie Bahrain in one of the early vintage Racecos. Competitors in the cross-country series compete in the production vehicle and special vehicle categories, with brother Wade and Grant Perrins among the more consistent crews in the special vehicle category in the Lalette Sadmaster. It was not a happy event for Stan Illman and Franz Stangl, who 2 years ago won their class in a Porsche 911. They roared the Carrera Motors Raceco in the time trial and were forced to withdraw. The Fissokron gear combination and a Toyota Hilux were the fastest of the Class E competitors in the time trial. While Fisser and Crondier went their merry way, there were problems for Paddy Driver and Tony Salvage when the Videosport Range Rover came to a halt with a broken radius arm.
They can fix that up and weld it and make it a bit stronger, and we'll keep going again.
On the motorcycle front, five times winner Alfie Cox was an outright favourite on the Pro Action Castrol KTM, but took it easy to set the eighth fastest time. Springbok Errol Dalton has not been a regular in this year's off-road series, but made a welcome return on the Shimbles Yamaha and was sixth fastest in the time trial. The flamboyant Willie Ireland on the SKF Delmas Diesel Suzuki carried a race cap fitted to his helmet. Dramatic footage provides for a graphic picture of what it takes to ride a motorcycle on the roof of Africa. Legendary figure in South African off-road racing, Charlie Tisson now lives in the United States, but was back to renew old acquaintance with the race. Tisson's now in the veterans category, and it was one of the young lions of South African off-road racing who set the pace in the time trial. The Suzuki office equipment rider, Yuri Hillman, is a real flyer, and on a couple of occasions this season has been in with a chance of winning a national event. Hillman set a cracking pace in the time trial, but was beaten by surprise package Tom Clarkson on a Kawasaki who led the 500 class. The Intrepid quad races always provide for some spectacular action, with the quads this year enjoying national championship status for the first time. It's tough work manhandling a quad over rough terrain, and it was Francois Coutier on a Suzuki who was the quickest of the quads on the time trial. Italian Richard Manning, winner of the Land Rover Barberspun 1000 earlier in the season, led home the 200 class motorcycles on the Winston Yamaha. Bloemfontein rider Graham McLaughlin was second fastest in the 200 class on the Lesotho office equipment Kawasaki. And while the competitors were hard at work out on the route, race officials were equally busy at rally headquarters. A comprehensive radio network kept track of competitors' progress through various checkpoints, with times and results radioed back to the official scorers. Tom Clarkson was the surprise name in the top 10 in the motorcycle time trial results. The other top 10ers were all expected to be in the leading group. On the car side, Harry Roscoe grabbed pole position in the single-seater Raceco. A feature of the results was the fact that only two production vehicles were in the top 10. conditions were expected to favour the special vehicles, with little prospect of rain. As is usual on off-road events, there was an early morning start, with an air of tension starting to come to the surface.